You weren't kidding when you said you were a fourth quarter player, huh?
I mean, yeah. It's a requirement, you know, for if we're being ambitious.
How tough was that, especially when you guys played the last 6 minutes, I think without a timeout? Just kind of walk us through what you guys were talking about during that and trying to, you know, prevent the...
Of course, there was the threat of Durant and Booker. That was our major concern, you know, playing the Suns, especially in the fourth quarter. So, and it worked really well in the first quarter, the energy we brought. So we really tried to find this again, to lock in, to know our rotations, our tactics. And otherwise, there was way less offensive tactics in the fourth quarter. It was, since we didn't have no more timeout, we had to listen to the coach what play he wants, and then go get a bucket.
Do you feel like this is the most your teammates look to you to be that scorer, lob the ball to you, get it to you in your spots?
I mean, I don't know. It might be, but you know, if you know, every game is different, and it's already our third win. And we, you know, every game we try to find the spot where we need to hurt them, you know. And today might have been in this way, and tomorrow it will be someone else, you know. It's how great teams work, you know. We want to be great. We need to play with everyone.
What was different for you in the first half, you know, with the strong start, and just for the team in general, getting out in transition?
It all started in the defense, in the defensive side. I know, you know, the energy we brought in, it's pretty much all we talked about. You know, they got so good offensive players that was the spot that where we needed to, you know, to focus on. And it worked, especially in the first half. You know, we took a big lead.
After they tied the score in the fourth quarter, you scored 10 of the team's next 12 points. Did you feel like that was your responsibility at that point for you to take over?
I mean, somebody's got to do it, you know. As I told you before, tomorrow is going to be one of my teammates. Two days ago, I mean, it was Keldon, you know. This is how we work as a group, as a team.
What do you think of Zach today on both ends of the floor?
You know, he's a tough man. He did a great job, I think, being smart and staying, you know, lucid up there. And he's always solid, you know. And I know he was a great contributor to the win today.
You're still getting physically acclimated to the league, so when you get a guy like Nurkic out of the game and you play pretty much a quarter, how does that help your confidence and altering, you know, the Sun shots when they come into the paint and such?
Talking on the defense, offense?
Defense.
When I'm trying to defend, I mean, it's, you know, it's always been, I've always had guys trying to go into me, but it's just the way it is. Of course, the NBA got the greatest athletes on earth, but so far it's working out pretty well.
You're matching some things that haven't been done since, you know, as a rookie, since Shaq, David Robinson, Akeem. What does that feel? What's that like to be in that kind of company?
You know, just makes me want to go even higher to beat all these records.
Five games into your career, you know, what's the biggest thing you've learned so far, and, you know, just getting adjusted to the league?
The biggest thing I've learned, I'd say, is maybe a 20-point lead is nothing, you know. It works both ways, and this is also something we see in FIBA when we play Team USA and when we scout Team USA. You know, you're going to be up 15, and in a blink, you're going to be down one, and you don't know what happened because they ran the fast break like crazy and they made just some defensive stops. So, yeah, and in the NBA, it's the same. I believe this 20-plus lead is really nothing.
Thanks. We'll take a couple of them for us. Go ahead, John.
The three you hit over Eubanks, when you guys came down the court, were you thinking to yourself, okay, I'm going to put this away right here? Like, this is my time to make a dagger? You hit a three-pointer dribbling left around Eubanks. With
put this away, what do you mean?
To put you guys up 10 or 12, I think, to put the game away.
Yeah. You know, it's... At this point, it's more instinct, but yeah, in the fourth quarter, in the NBA, you just have to make big plays. You're not going to have many chances if you don't, you know, if you don't try to kill your opponent right away. Because, as I said before, they got some of the best offensive talent in the world, so you don't have many chances.
Thanks for doing a couple of friends.
Après le match à LA, Pop a parlé fort en disant Travis, ça sera notre leader, notre équipe. Et après, il l'a ajouté tout de suite après. Et quand j'arrêterai de le retenir, qu'est-ce que tu penses qu'il voulait dire par là? Est-ce que ce soir, tu as l'impression que justement, il t'a lâché dans l'arène, en gros, et qu'il s'est donné un peu l'équipe?
Je dirais pas ça, mais je pense que ce qu'il voulait dire, c'est que je fais des erreurs de rookie. Ce qui est normal et donc disons que le coach, sa priorité, c'est de faire gagner l'équipe. Donc bien sûr, il peut pas me laisser faire n'importe quoi. Mais aujourd'hui, au final, ça dépend plus de moi, de mes choix, de faire de bonnes décisions et de respecter ses consignes. Et je pense que c'est ça qui mènera vers une grande liberté et ouais, des bonnes performances. Si je fais un meilleur match, c'est sûrement que j'ai fait les meilleurs choix.
Victor, tu es devenu le Français le plus rapide à passer la barre des 30 points. Qu'est-ce que ça représente? Est-ce qu'on peut dire que ce soir, c'est l'acte de naissance un petit peu de Victor Wembanyama en NBA? Tu le vois comme ça?
Non, je ne le vois pas comme ça, mais peut-être que dans le futur, je reste au niveau de ses performances, on pourra considérer ça, oui, comme un début, mais je ne savais pas, mais pour le record des Français, mais c'est une fierté, bien sûr. C'est pas que pour moi, j'espère, mais pour la France. Et je sais que beaucoup, j'espère, en bénéficieront dans le futur en France, mais pas que moi.
Thanks, Vic. That's all we got time. Thank you. Let's go.
Have a good night.